Michael, I want to ask you, we were just told by Rolling Stone that the reporter in question is not going to be fired from the magazine. What first made you skeptical of the story?
Well, you know, I mean, there's a dozen red flags when I first read the story. And, you know, I got to the story a little late. A few people actually had read the story and raised some red flags. So I went to this, go over it. And the first thing I realized is that it's a single source story. And, you know, I mean, there are other people that talk in the story, but Jackie's account is the only one. There are a number of things that you see in the story. An example, when, you know, recently she claims to have been hit in the face with a bottle that smashed in her face, gave her a black eye, bloodied, and this is all, you know, in public. There's no one else to corroborate that. There's no sort of medical evidence. There's no police reports. And so, you know, in something that's this horrific, it doesn't mean that something that's this horrific couldn't happen. Of course, that can, it can happen. But there was this sort of mounting sense that I got when reading it, that with just one source, you really, as journalists, we have to check this stuff out because, you know, as we heard, I mean, it affects the fraternity, it affects policy that is being made, and a lot of people's lives will be affected by this, by these claims.
Right, but Michael, if I can play devil's advocate for a second here, the lawyer's statement, the lawyer who represents the fraternity, his statement is very specific. He denies that sexual assault is a part of the initiation. He doesn't deny that there was ever a sexual assault or even in the last few years in the fraternity. He says that the person in question, the individual that belonged to this club or worked at this club was not a member of the fraternity, but he doesn't say no members of the fraternity raped anybody in the previous 2 years. Am I reading too much into how specific he is in his denials?
You might be. I mean, I think that what he's doing is responding specifically to this allegation, and the allegation that is, I mean, people have said to me a number of times, something could have happened. You know, this is absolutely true. Something could have, and it could have been inflated quite a bit. But, you know, what we're responding to is a very, very specific allegation in Rolling Stone. Those of us who have questioned this, their lawyer. Now, I have to say that what he is saying, that there was no party the night that she said that there was a party, the person that it seems to be that she's naming, we don't even know who the person is, really. It's not even clear the Rolling Stone journalist knew who the person was. That person was a member of a different fraternity. So, I mean, he might be being evasive because in this story, everyone is being evasive. Rolling Stone has been evasive. They seem to be essentially blaming, you know, the victim herself for, I mean, which she should for sort of in you know, creating something bigger than it was. But they should also be blaming themselves, their editors, and they should be blaming the journalists for not doing due diligence.
And Sarah.